Okay, Mr. Garrick, Richmond Garrick, and I teach at Williamstown High School in Williamstown, New Jersey.
Okay. And can you tell me about the piece, It's Not Okay? What inspired that?
The inspiration came from the fact that originally I'm from Sierra Leone in West Africa, and we were engaged in a nasty civil war, and that claimed my brother's life because my brother was killed during the war. So when I was in graduate school, I received news that he had been killed. So I wanted to use my work to speak about these issues, to articulate issues of brutality, you know, but at the same time, to deal with my pain that I was going through, you know. So I started painting, you know, dealing with themes that would have a dialogue of these some socio-political activities within my work. But then I wanted to express it through the medium, through the physicality of the process. Yes.
Yeah, I noticed, I was going to ask you about that. And just being involved with a lot of the things that are happening in the Middle East, I completely understand using the medium as the message. But do you feel like that message is being received by your students and by people who view your work?
Yes, yes, certainly. Certainly, because in fact, as a teacher, I have a unique background. You know, because the kids born in this country, I always tell them they are really fortunate. You see, because presently in the world, you have child soldiers phenomenon that's going on. And you have well over 35,000 kids that are being forced to fight beyond their will. And on the painting, It's Not Okay, that's a child soldier. And I'm showing that these kids have been put in situations where they would either be killed or their life would be destroyed for life.
Yeah, it's a very painful, painful topic. And sometimes I always wonder if Americans really can understand what that brings about. So when a person views your work, and you use, I think it's oils that you use, a lot of oil, do you purposely choose oil? And what do you want that person, the viewer, to walk away with?
When the viewer comes into the gallery, I want the work to command presence so that you can't walk past it. That's why I work on larger size canvases, like 3 feet by 4 feet, you know, 7 feet by 7 feet, you know, and the way the paint is applied, very, very thick, almost like sculpture, you know, like someone sculpting, you know, so that it can invoke the emotion of what I'm feeling inside. And I believe that my viewer gets that, you know, because even the little kids who were here just now, we are reacting, you know, to the thickness of the work, to the physicality of the didactic nature of the medium. They were reacting towards that, you know. And the colors that I'm using, you know, are colors that are really earth tones,
right.
You know, like
red,
you know,
yes,
exactly.
Yeah.
And these colors reflect blood, you know, so instead of actually making the painting look gory,
right.
I take away the gory nature from the work and let the work speak through the medium, through the process.
So it's like a thickness, which is almost like a touch,
yes,
almost.
An impasto, yes.
Right. And then my last question, my Kindle went out on me. But with the piece, It's Not Okay, it's the, as you said, the story of a child soldier. So the picture that you did called Hope, is, I'm glad you gave me the brochure again because I saw it online and I meant to ask you about that. Was that just to contrast It's Not Okay? What's going on with Hope?
That painting, Hope, was one of the paintings that I was doing while I was looking for a way, a vehicle to express myself. Because if you look at that painting, it's not as thick,
right,
when you look at the picture.
It's very thin.
Yeah, yes, exactly, exactly. So I was trying to articulate these issues, but then with that painting, I found out that it speaks more to the theme, but it doesn't have the emotionality that I want. You know, it doesn't have the anger that you would feel through the brush strokes. But again, but when you look at the painting itself, it is a paradox, because I'm dealing with things that are not pleasant, but yet still, people see beauty within the work, through which the medium is used, through the juxtaposition, you know, of the brush strokes, you know, the didactic nature of it, you know, and the process. And I believe that my viewers standing in front of the work can actually feel my hands through the work. And at the same time, they are being confronted with issues that normally you would read in the newspaper within the sacrosanct temple of the gallery and painting. You know, so my viewers are having a direct dialogue with the work. And I've seen people look at the work and it forces them to move away from the work, you know, and yet still they come closer to the work and they want to touch it, you know, and that's the kind of dialogue they are having. And while they're doing that, they're actually searching and trying to piece this puzzle together within the work. And they see things within the work that are not even intended. You know?
So do you encourage your students to paint from the heart in issues that matter? How do you encourage students, young artists, in their field?
I encourage my students to be true to themselves, especially when you're within academia, you know, and you're going to graduate school. You have to be true to your own thoughts, your own expression, you know, because people try to influence us. And I mean, professors would make suggestions, you know, in terms of the direction you should go and what and where to express yourself. But at the end of the day, you know, you are the one dealing with your work. And you must be able to articulate your ideas intellectually through the medium. You must have effective command of the medium, effective command of your subject matter, you know, and with all of these suggestions that you have, you try to find a way to express it where it would be more pragmatic and at the same time achieving your goal as an artist, you know, as an intellectual, you know, in a way that you as an artist, you'll be able to, or as an educator, will be able to talk about your work and use your work as a medium to influence and motivate others.
Mr. Garrick, I want to thank you so much for your time. I was really looking forward to interviewing you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Have a great time. All right, bye-bye.